Hello, I'm Mr. Harniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. You don't need to believe me. You have to find it yourself. If you are solitary, if you are not solitary, you can't find it. So you need to be a virgin in order to find him. So here it is, the royal kingdom of God and how to enter it. This is John the Baptist. He is holding scripture in his hand. And he taught scripture to the people. And those who believed in him and became tribal people, not Jew outwardly, most of them had become Jew outwardly. When you become Jew outwardly, then you renounce your tribal identity. People of Judah tribe started Judaism to Jew. Most of the people of Judah tribe, they were Jew outwardly. And they broke their covenant with Abraham. Because Abraham was not a Jew outwardly, but of heart. Heart. A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. Outwardly, they were of Judah tribe. From Judah tribe, they changed it to Jew. And they were making Gentile and other people Jew, telling them that they are now son of Abraham through circumcision. Chapter 17, Genesis 17, is full of corruption. So first know what you see with two naked eyes. Then what is not seen of God would be known to you, that you need to be sensible people. And that's where John the Baptist comes. First know your tribal father, and then you will know your spiritual father. Whose vineyard is this one, where the true wine, Christ Jesus, has been planted. We need to graft ourselves to this true vine. To do so, you have to enter through this narrow gate, which has the burning bush. Kill enough his word. That's why Jesus, I have brought fire, and this is the fire. And you need to be solitary, because this narrow gate is only for one person. Not two together. And here you need to have a clean heart when you want to enter here. No mammon attraction. You can't serve mammon and God. So you have to be 100% devoted to God. As the first church, when it was formed, people sold their possessions to buy this field. This is the field. Whereas two Anans and Sapphira, they sold their possession, but they kept back money. That means they had attraction for Mammon. And Peter won't let them in. He killed them. Peter is supposed to feed the sheep through this narrow gate. People who are truthful, 100% devoted to God, they were allowed inside here. Today you go to church, it's full of hypocrites. So they are solitary. And these people, they are not under the domination of mammon, as sadhus are, sadhus of Melchizedek type. So these people who are Melchizedek type, those who are from the first community of Church of God, they have zero attraction for mammon. And one of the person went to Iraq area to cure a king of gouts. And when he cured many diseases, and when he wanted to leave, the king of that country offered him gifts. He refused to accept it. He has said, we have given our, and why should we accept your, that you have got out of the blood money of the people? By taking, it was not, his gifts were not of hard earned. earned money of his own. Other people earned for him. So it was a blood money, sweat money, which they refused to take. So you need to be a sadhu of Melchizedek type to be in the royal kingdom of God. And this is what this parable I'm going to do. The woman which married the seventh husband, whose wife she will be. And I'm going to explain this one. I hope you will understand it. And it is very simple. If you have the longing for gospel, if you don't have longing for gospel, you can't understand it. So let's read it and then I will explain it. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Pabram, etc., delivered by the first anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call SATGUR, Jesus, according to St. Luke 27-40. Some Sadducees are the moral teacher, you know.
And the intake of the moral teachers are one small disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline, and they discipline them by teaching them the moral law of Moses. Whereas in Jesus, we are not disciples. We are laborers employed in the vineyard of our Father. You need to be sensible person to enter that one. So some Sadducees, those who deny that there is a resurrection, came forward and put this question to Jesus, saying, Teacher, Moses wrote for us, if someone's brother dies, leaving a wife, but no child, his brother must take the wife and raise up descendants for his brother. So she remained solitary. That means no children, not involved in sacral life, as the sadhus are. Now, the Jesus, it is using analogy. And the Pharisee Sadducee, they were talking about this moral thing, you know, morality. And Jesus was interpreting it in spirituality. Spiritual, because he was the Christ. He was not a rabbi. Rabbis teach the moral law of Moses, or of the demiurge called Yahweh. That's what John the Baptist was, an ideal rabbi, or Prophet Elijah. Prophet Elijah means my God is Yahweh. Yahweh is the creator of this one. That's why the name of Jesus was Yeshua, made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother, and Joseph was foster father of Judah tribe. So Mary, so you can see that this is also implicit proof of the virgin birth of Jesus, that he had no tribal father, but Yahweh was his father, heavenly father. That's why when people were selling, trading in the courtyard of the temple, which belonged to Yahweh, the inner, the curtain of the holiest of holy, which had the holiest of holy curtain, that was is of heart, which is higher than this one. So, this is the curtain, and this is the holiest of holy. You can't see, but you have to perceive. Royal kingdom of God is inside here. Kingdom of heaven is out in law and order. So there are two different kingdoms. You can see here. This is the kingdom of the rabbinic law and order scripture. They taught scripture to their disciples to discipline them how to behave. And the
the popularity or the credit of the rabbi is seen by these disciples, how he trained them, how law and order is in the country where he is the in charge, the ruler. And this is the royal kingdom of God, which is inner, holiest of holy temple, inner one, which is our heart. Because gospel is written over here, not in ink on paper. Because you have to do logical reasoning yourself to brew logo. And logo is his word. So this is the royal kingdom of God of the heart. Just the opposite. What apply to flesh, the opposite apply to spirit. So here you are, the solitary, you know, solitary means that you are not under the domination of anyone. Remember the centurion whose servant was sick, and he invited Jesus, send his people, go and ask him to come and cure this, his servant. When he was coming, Jesus, then he sent message, I'm not worthy to entertain you, because he was not a solitary one. He was under the domination of the Roman emperor. So he stopped him, you know. He said, just say the word and it will be okay. So such people who are under the domination, and they have soldiers under them, soldiers and children, such people are not virgins. They are married to the Roman emperors. So whatever Roman emperors say, they do it. Like people who do what the will of the Pope, they are married to Pope. Whatever Pope say, they will do it. And Pope is Antichrist. Because in Jesus, everyone has to give his own account to God. So Pope can't stand between man and God. I went to a Kirchentag in Germany, a Catholic one. And over there, a Catholic priest was very well dressed, newly washed robe and very shining, you know. And he was standing there. And I asked him, brother, when Jesus died, the curtain of the holiest of holy torn from top to bottom. Then the temple high priest to the village rabbi, off you go. Can you tell me where you stand between man and God? Oh, I'm a guide. I said, what about if you are a blind guide? To get rid of you, you know, Jesus died on the cross. And you say you are a guide? Blind guide. Then I told him, anybody who stands between man and God, he is Antichrist and you are one of them. So this is the Antichrist. Here you are. This is the rabbinic system, moon and star. That is the Islam of this Ismullah Islam. Pope stand here. And this is a saint. Nobody can stand between God and men, because everyone has to give his own account to God. So this is the saint, these are angels. John the Baptist was here, witness to the light, but not the light. So he preached, this is a witness to the light that I'm living, because soul is inside me. If I'm dead, then this flesh will rot. So many things you can learn. Just sit down and you will, through intuition, it's all in here. If you are not capable of thinking yourself, then you are spiritually dead. And you will go and read the dead letters of the books, like this book or Bible, dead letter. And you will see, but you won't be able to perceive it, the perception, which is the top root of the Scripture, which is his word, Oral Torah,
which Jesus came to deliver. And the people of Judah tribe, they killed him. So she was solitary. She remained solitary. In Jesus, our soul is concerned. And soul has no masculine or feminine gender. But we are virgin brides of our Father. And we are to remain virgin to marry him only, to do his will only. Nobody stands between man and God. And that is what it is, you know, that you have to have a direct approach to God through his word. That is why Jesus tore the curtain of the holiest of holy. So people have direct approach to God through his word, not by prayer or fasting. Prayer and fasting is here. That was the temple outside of the Father of Jesus, yes, of Yahweh's Father, Yahweh's temple. Yahweh is the God of nature, Lord of the nature. He is demiurge. He is dead without soul in the person. So here it will become clear that what virgin means. So here are, you know, these six parts. They are created by Yahweh. Three and three. Three are holy, three are evil people. Where there are holy people, there are evil people as well. This is Yahweh, creation part. This is Elohim in the middle, Father of our souls. And his first you light this candle, and then you light the other one. So he is the source of our souls. And so these people, secular people like the centurion and other people, they were under domination. Sorry, okay, I will do in part.